Fishin Affliction. Hello.
Rise and shine. It's Fishin Affliction time. For those who got it bad.
Well, Mom and Dad's grab the kids, it's time for the fishing show. Me and old Rusty's gonna go catch them down at the fishing hole. Well, you better stick around, cause you don't know what you're missing. Yeah, me and old Rusty's got that fishing affliction. Grab your hats, grab your baits, and don't forget your poles. We're gonna fire up that old Ranger boat and head to the fishing hole. We're gonna try to catch a big one. Yeah, that's what we're wishing. Cause me and old Rusty's got that fishing affliction. Yeah, me and old Rusty's got that fishing affliction. Yeah. Man, and we've got it bad.
We've got that fishing affliction.
Just like me. Here, fishy, fishy, here, fishy, fishy, here, fishy, fishy, here, fishy, fishy, here.
What are you videoing?
I'm videoing my personal breakfast.
Oh my goodness.
Now, where are we going today?
We're going to Alabama. If you start the truck and get us moving and quit eating.
Rise and shine. It's Fishin Affliction time. Thank you for tuning in this morning. Hey everybody, this is your old pal Matthew Gillen, the voice of Fishin Affliction here at the HD Studios. By popular request, we are pulling another great episode from the Fishin Affliction Video Vault. As this week, we're going to join Dan and the Big Dawg on Guntersville with renowned guide Troy Jans. And I'm telling you, folks, they catch some great fish. This should be wonderful. Hey, don't forget, at the end of the show, we're going to be announcing our weekly Team Fishin Affliction T-shirt giveaway winner. And if you've entered, hey, it just could be you. If you haven't entered, please take a few minutes and do so after the show. I'll tell you more about that later. Sit back and enjoy this encore presentation from the Fishin Affliction Video Vault on Fishin Affliction TV.
Well, it's getting a little bigger.
It looks like a fairly decent fish.
Ain't too bad. Most of the ones on Guntersville are born bigger than this. They ain't born bigger than this on this lake. I don't know where this would come from. It must come from Smith Lake. Right out. That color right there, those natural colors is what I really, really like on this lake. Any natural shad color is always good on Lake Guntersville. Get a little fish here to start the day.
Now folks, as you can hear, it's another windy day. And no matter what you try to do to keep the wind off the microphone, it's just next to impossible. And that wind is part of that cold front that we're in trying to catch these fish in this 49 degree water. You know, it's really interesting to watch somebody that has the skill and a knowledge base of both Rusty and Troy sitting there just plying their wares, trying to catch fish in tough conditions. And you know, there's so much to learn when two guys of this caliber are slinging baits at these bass and having a little fun along the way.
All right, come on, come on. That wasn't a guide strike, it really was a fish. You saw him.
Are you sure that
Big Dawg, did you see a fish?
I didn't see anything.
I don't know.
I saw a bird up
there. Well, I'm not sure now.
Thank you, pal.
See that little, you know, when you're untangling your lure like that? That little lure dance? You know what they call that?
What is that?
Detango.
Detango. Oh, my goodness.
There's another one that just hatched. I think this one hatched yesterday. They're liking that little, what is that color called now? We got that.
It's a, I call it a glass shad.
Glass shad. And that's a new color?
Yeah.
Yeah, so far these little fish are liking it. They got her hung up in there pretty good. Get me hung up in there pretty good. Here's my flyer.
Right here.
Oh, all right, thank you. G- glass shad. Even little fish got pretty stout bodies on them here on Guntersville. They're just a great, healthy lake with the cover and the bait fish keeps this lake in really good shape. Yeah. A lot of the anglers are working really, really hard to try to keep the cover in the lake and the grass and the management so we can keep a good, healthy population of fish. And now it's become one of the top tournament lakes, top tournament destinations in the country.
But that is just a baby right there, isn't it?
That is just a baby. Like I say, born bigger than that, most of them, so I don't know.
So far, I'm reserving my comments until I catch one.
Well, I know that Troy and I, we both have one in the boat.
I think Troy's got three in the boat or something.
We've got fish, that's what I'm saying.
That's right.
That's right, folks. I almost forgot to show you my fish. And it was caught on a Strike King Pure Poison. I'd like to dedicate this fish to the big dog, Rusty Rust.
Oh my goodness gracious.
And I told you.
A pure poison. Catching them on a pure poison.
That's right. So they normally are born bigger than this right here, Troy?
Yeah, I don't know where those come from.
Folks, we'll be back in just a minute with some more Fishin' Affliction. But right now, here's some pictures from
In the Wild. Your pictures in the wild. Brought to you by Express Flensing. Your home for low price, self-serve, auto parts, saving you money.
Well, folks, there's no doubt that spring is just around the corner, and these are some great pictures sent to us from U.S. Army Corps of Engineers Park Ranger Catherine Wall, who took these great pictures, including this one of this little fox looking at these geese and then coming on down to the water's edge to get him a little sip of that cool water. Thanks again to Park Ranger Catherine Wall for those great pictures. Folks, you can send your pictures to pics@fishandaffliction.com and be sure to check out the picture galleries there at fishandaffliction.com and send us those pictures because maybe you'll see them right here on the big screen.
In the wild, your pictures in the wild. Brought to you by Express Cleansing. Your home for low price, self-serve, auto parts, saving you money.
Kevin, what are you doing here?
Oh, I'm just filling in for Billy.
I need 660 shad crankbaits in the Series 5 model.
We're out.
You're not out. You got all kinds of them right there.
We're out.
Kevin, I need six.
Have a lollipop.
I do not want a lollipop.
Have a lollipop.
Do you have it in sexy shad color?
Big Dog, where do you go when you need a gigantic selection of used auto parts at great prices?
Where everybody goes, Express Pull and Save in Laverne, Tennessee.
Conveniently located, Express Pull and Save offers a huge and continually updated inventory of vehicles for your automotive needs. Their simple, state-of-the-art customer service terminal will help you locate the parts so you can pull and save. From exterior parts like bumpers, taillights, wheels, and rims to those hard-to-find interior items such as switches, mirrors, and seats, the friendly and courteous staff of Express Pull and Save makes it so easy to pull and save, even if you're the big dog.
Hey, big dog.
What?
Pull and Save's on that side of the fence.
But don't you think these will look good on the Ranger?
Express Pull and Save, your home for low price, self-serve auto parts.
Smyrna Ready Mix is an established company that handles business daily with integrity and professionalism. Whether you're a general contractor, professional builder, or do-it-yourself homeowner, SRM has your concrete solutions. With several locations in the Middle Tennessee area to serve you, Smyrna Ready Mix offers a wide variety of concrete mix designs, admixtures, reinforcing products, aggregates, and much more to meet the exacting requirements of any construction project you have, from the biggest to the littlest. Smyrna Ready Mix is here to benefit you with unmatched quality and service. SRM, serving you with integrity and professionalism.
tournament trail for those who've got it bad. Brought to you by SRM Smyrna Ready Mix, serving you with professionalism and integrity.
Well, folks, here's the Trinity Netminders Club Tournament results held on Dale Hollow Lake on March the 5th, 2011. First place with 20.71 pounds went to the team of Darren Walker and Jason Dunn. Second place with 17.84 pounds went to the team of Brock Jones and Noel Smith. Now, the first big fish weighed 7.01 pounds and was caught by the team of Darren Walker and Jason Dunn. And the second big fish weighed 4.71 pounds and was caught by Randy Loftus and Billy Gardner. Thanks to Noel Smith for providing that information, and congratulations to the winners. Folks, you can send your tournament results to info@fishandaffliction.com, and be sure to check out all the tournament trail links there at fishandaffliction.com so you can keep up with all of those who are on the trail. Thanks to Smyrna Ready Mix for being the sponsor of the Fishin' Affliction Tournament Trail. And now, back to Fishin' Affliction.
Folks, you're watching an encore presentation from the Fishin' Affliction Video Vault.
Come out of that other mud line.
It's a monster.
I don't know about a monster.
You're supposed to get down on the deck and squall around and scream and yell and holler.
I should have.
That's just when he loaded the boat up.
I tell you what, now I'm ready for these things to grow up today. I know we got a cold front on us, but this is Lake Guntersville.
Big dog, was that a fish that you just threw back real quick that I didn't even get to see on the camera?
Well, if you didn't, that's just tough. I'm going to catch some more.
You are geared up to catch them, man. Don't tell anybody what you just did now. I'll overdub it.
Well, thank you.
Overdub it. Catching gun is for a largemouth through the fine tunes of Mr. Troy Jens.
They're going to think we're fishing at
Cleveland. W-G-E-N-S.
It's all the same, just politics and the crazy blame game.
Hold it in here. He's got it where I don't want to get it. Mouth in. Another pretty one.
Troy, we're listening to a song as you caught that fish. Tell me a little bit about that.
That's a song I wrote actually and recorded in Muscle Shoals at the place called the Nut House for our soldiers at Christmas, this past Christmas.
And it got played, you were saying.
It did, it sure did.
That's
we
awesome.
Got a lot of emails and whatnot for remembering our troops at Christmas overseas and what they're going through. And I mean, the great appreciation that we should have in this country for them is just, really, we've got to stand together and support them. And I think each one of us should do everything we can do, and I try to use whatever gift I have to do that.
Well, the song is beautiful. I'm listening forward to playing it for the folks on the show.
Oh,
putting up
great.
Some information and everything. And it doesn't hurt the fishing any.
No.
How about that?
They don't mind music. They like country music out here. Steel guitar thing.
Yeah, I hear you, brother. That's great.
Some of those others didn't hatch yesterday. So.
Now, are we looking at male fish here?
Yeah. Well, I don't. Yeah, I believe we are.
That's probably what they're doing. They're stacking up, getting ready to hit these beds.
We got to keep them pliers handy. I don't know how many we've caught.
That's about a half dozen already.
So,
that's five in the front of the boat standing and one in the back.
I hear you. See the reddish on them there. It's typical of the cold water this time of year. So, but they're eating that glass shad.
Isn't that great?
Yeah, they really are. Natural colors, I think, are great, especially a little darker natural colors on these dark days like this. But you can't go wrong if you're throwing a natural color. A lot of people are always undecided or underconfident or wondering what color they should be throwing. But there's one right there. As long as it's a natural color, he come off. See, that really was good. As long as it's a natural color, I believe they'll eat it.
Now tell me, this is just one of the lakes that you actually guide upon.
Right, I guide a lot on Lake Wheeler. And we do a lot of tournament guiding down there, I do. And then I do a little bit of guiding for smallmouth down on Lake Wilson. And I really enjoy that when I get a chance to go down there.
And the folks are seeing your information right now up on the screen, so make sure you give Mr. Troy Jens a phone call because he can put you on some fish on any lake that you want to go on.
We'll try hard, that's for
all
sure.
All the way from the Great Lakes?
Well, not the Great Lakes.
Well, the Great Lakes of Alabama.
The Great Lakes of Alabama.
Yeah, the Great Lakes of Alabama.
And they are great in Alabama. Aren't they?
Well, folks, I hope you're enjoying this encore presentation from the HD video vaults of Fishin Affliction. And in a moment, we'll be right back with some more great fish in action. But right now, let's go see a classic recipe from the video vaults of...
In the Skillet with Chef Vicki Porter is brought to you by Kleepy.com, turning your precious memories into video treasures.
Welcome to In the Skillet. I'm Vicki Porter, and today I will be showing you a great recipe for tilapia with white wine and tomatoes. And now for the ingredients. You will need 4 tilapia fillets, 4 tablespoons of olive oil, 3 teaspoons of minced garlic, 4 teaspoons of dried basil, 1 cup of white wine, 1 can of diced tomatoes, salt and pepper to taste, a splash of lemon juice, and top it off with shredded Parmesan cheese. Place the tilapia fillets in a 9x13 bowl and season with salt and pepper. Then cover each piece with 1 tablespoon of olive oil. Next, we're going to sprinkle on the garlic. Next, put basil on top of each fillet. Next, we're going to top it off with tomatoes. Add a splash of lemon juice. Top it off with Parmesan cheese. And last, pour the whole cup of wine over the fish. Cover it with aluminum foil and bake it in the oven on 425 for 20 minutes. Wow, 20 minutes later and look how good this tilapia looks. I can't wait to eat it. I'm gonna dig in before Rusty and Dan find this. You can find this recipe number 7 at fishinaffliction.com. I'm Vicki Porter and tune in next week to see what's cooking in the skillet.
I am Strike King.
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 Big Dog, I've got the need for outdoor radio. I need fishing reports. I need to know what's going on in the world of the outdoors. Where do I go?
You need to listen to Doug Markham.
On 99.7 WTN every Saturday from 5 to 7 a.m. and you might even hear these two.
I know you're checking out my t-shirt. Do you want one of these t-shirts? Go to fishinaffliction.com and you can see how you can win one of these great looking t-shirts yourself.
For hunters only, brought to you by Fishin Affliction. For those who've got it bad, both on the water and in the woods.
Folks, let's join Affliction Pro staffer Catfish as he films his friend Jason Bale on a late season squirrel hunt. Well, folks, a late season squirrel hunt is a great way to spend some time in the woods after deer season. All you have to do is grab your favorite .22 and find yourself a ridge and start doing a little walking, paying attention to where those bushy tails might be hiding.
Well, we got these 3 right here. That's the couple. Getting a little warm, so we'll go back, clean them, put them in the cooler where they won't burn, and we're gonna head back out. Try to get a few more.
Well, congratulations to Jason Bale for a great late season squirrel hunt. And now, back to Fishin' Affliction.
It's time for Fishin' 101, brought to you by Maryville Middle Bass Club. Now here's Carla.
Thanks,
guys. If you've got a bad like Dan and Rusty, you've probably been fishing all winter long. But for many of us, the cold weather means more time at home and less time on the lake. But don't let the winter weather get you down, because that's the best time to get ready for spring. First, inspect your reels. Clean them, oil them, re-spoil them if needed, and replace any malfunctioning parts. By doing it now, you'll have plenty of time to order and receive any needed parts. Winter is also a great time to clean those lures. You can clip knots and line, change hooks, and replace any components if needed. And once you've got your lures in top shape, it's also a great time to organize. Think about what your needs are and organize your equipment so that it's easy to access when you're on the water. I'm Carla, and this has been Fishing 101 with the Maryville Middle School Bass Club.
Well, folks, I hope you're enjoying this highly requested encore presentation of Fishin Affliction straight from the HD video vaults. And this portion of the show is brought to you by the ever-powerful DECA Gel Batteries and Kistler Rods. Fishing never felt so good. And now, back to some more fishing on Lake Guntersville.
There's one right behind you.
Jig fish on Guntersville this year.
Goodbye.
I got me one. Another All right. giant here. A little bite is on. That's not good.
Hey, that one's fighting harder than mine did, or else you got a real light action rod, which makes it look big.
It's bigger than yours was.
That's twice as big as.
But he's bigger than yours was.
Twice as big as Russ.
Hey, thank you. You know what? Still I'll tell you one big, thing. I would prefer for it to be about 10 degrees warmer, maybe 20 degrees warmer.
20 or 30.
What is the deal with the, I got to daggum fish in a polar ice cap every place we go this year.
Man, I don't got drag. That's more like the kind of fish we're trying to find right there. Don't have drag. If I can get him without getting me hooked too, I'll be all right. There we go. All right, he's still not big, but
pliers.
Yeah, we'll need the pliers to unhook him. I don't want him getting in the gills. I think we're going to be good. All right, thanks, sir.
Still working the
glass shad, I guess. That's what that color of the red eye shad. So, pretty gunnersome fish right there.
I got a good chunky fish.
Yeah, you feel measure. Maybe. Still short for gunnersome standards, but we'll take them.
I got a good chunky fish.
Yeah. Short of that.
Troy, we've pushed off out of the 1-2 foot, 3 foot range and gotten out here just a little bit deeper. Just picking up the other, are we trying to work an edge of the grass, basically, or?
We are. The newer grass is growing very shallow, and we've been catching some up there, but we're moving out here just a little to see if we can get some bigger fish on the very outer edge of the new growing grass. Now this deeper grass will be growing also real soon. So this will all be matted up. So we're trying to stay as close as we can as the new growing grass. That's where they'll be bedding. And after they bed in that new growing grass, the fry have a lot of protection because the grass just grows up around them, and a lot of the fish just stay there all summer.
That's a good chunk.
Good chunk.
Good chunky bass. Now he got it. It's on the outside of his mouth, but I really think he's trying to get it. Did you see that? God almighty, how he didn't get it on
the phone. Oh, yeah.
Jesus.
Right there.
Got him.
There he goes.
I got it.
Pretty chunky fish.
Oh man.
Yeah, that'll help.
That's nice.
That'll help boys and girls. Now that's a chunk. There's a chunk. Daggum boy. Takes the boy long enough, don't it?
Well, folks, what you just witnessed is absolutely one of the more classic moments here on Fishin Affliction. The big dog's top water bite down there on Guntersville with Troy Jens. And when the day was all said and done, the guys had some dandy fish to hold up, and it was time to say goodbye to a great day of fishing and a great time on the water with renowned guide Troy Jens.
All right, here's our four bassins for today. We ended up catching, you know, 6-7. We probably caught 20-something fish, wouldn't you say, Troy?
Yeah, at least that. Probably yeah. a good many more than that.
Most of them on the red eye. One good bite on a buzz bait, but we ended up having a pretty good day, you know. Not the biggest sack we ever caught, but it was an adverse cold front condition, so when you can catch a good solid sack, that's a good day bass fishing.
Absolutely. It's always good. Always good.
And I want to thank you for your time today, buddy.
Man, thank you. And, I enjoyed it. Really did.
And wish you luck on your children's ministry. And but anyway, we're to about 10 minutes before dark. We're getting ready to have to run in, and we're going to let these fish go.
Well, folks, we hope you've enjoyed this encore presentation of Fishin Affliction, and we hope that you join us next week for an exciting new show. And right now, it's time to find out who won the Team Fishin Affliction T-shirt.
Well, folks, it's time for the weekly Team Fishin Affliction T-shirt giveaway. And this week's winner of the great-looking Team Fishin Affliction T-shirt made by ACP Specialties in Hendersonville is Martin Polin of Springfield, Tennessee. Visit fishinaffliction.com to learn how you can become the weekly winner of a Team Fishin Affliction T-shirt at absolutely no cost to you. Plus, single episodes and box sets of the show are ready right now in the online store. Everyone who enters will be qualified for the Fishin Affliction Grand Prize drawing later this year. The grand prize is your very own Fishin Affliction episode. That's right, you will be the host of your own Fishin Affliction TV show along with Dan and Rusty. Plus, you'll also win an assortment of other fishing goodies to take on your grand prize adventure with Fishin Affliction TV. See website for official details. And if you don't have a computer, don't worry. Just drop us a line in the mail and you'll be entered. The address is Post Office Box 1302, Hendersonville, Tennessee, 37077. Remember, everyone who enters will be qualified for the awesome Fishin Affliction TV grand prize to be announced later this year. As always, a big thanks to our sponsors. And this is your old pal Matthew Gillen, the voice of Fishin Affliction TV, signing off from the Fishin Affliction HD studios, hoping that you'll tune in next week, because there's no doubt
Dan and the Big Dog got it bad. They got Fishin Affliction for those who got it bad.
Rusty's catch of the day.
I'll bet you anything.
Here, watch it.
Hey, you'll get a striking bait. Let's go.
Ain't nothing safe around me.